Well, we've been seeing the heat really cranking up, especially today across the state. Once again, triple digits along the Wasatch Front, making it day number 20 so far throughout the summer with those triple digit temperatures. Again, we're just focusing on Salt Lake City. Focusing on St. George right now, off in the distance, we've been seeing some thunderstorms pushing its way through, producing heavy rain, also gusty winds, Pine Valley Mountain, and now spilling over. Those thunderstorms still have the strength that they could produce those gusty winds, maybe some hail. And it's moving towards St. George. It's losing a little steam. So if it does sweep through that region, it's going to have less of an impact. But again, we're keeping that focus here for about the next hour or so. Temperatures, though, in St. George right now, as we're looking at temperatures in the 90s currently, as we show you, the temperatures just bumped up in St. George at 100. Winds out of the west at 15 miles per hour. Again, we're seeing those wind gusts a little bit stronger right now due to those thunderstorms off in the distance. We show you looking at satellite radar. Radar focus is active, seeing a lot of color. But again, earlier on, we had those really deep reds. Those are really heavy rains. Now tapering on just a little bit, you can see in its track, it's Gunlock, it's Ivins, down through St. George, southwestern Utah. That's going to be the focus where even moving further northward, potentially up through Milford, we can see that southwest quadrant of seeing those thunderstorms moving in. Now, this was the flash flood potential for today. It's a little bit of a concern, particularly as we go Zion National Park. It's probable in that orange category. Now, let's show you for tomorrow. We line things up where that moisture will be spreading across both south central, central into northeastern Utah. So as we look at Bryce Canyon, Grand Staircase, Zion National Park, even seeing a bigger concern come tomorrow. That's good news as far as bringing the moisture. Not good news, of course, with the possibility of flash flooding, but it's just an indication that that moisture increasing across the state. Now, temperatures in Salt Lake City in the triple digits. We look at the air quality. It's not bad. We've got moderate concern levels, kind of a mixture between green and yellow, and that's the situation throughout the state. We move further northwest, though. We've got, poor air quality, as you'd expect. Northern California up through Oregon. We're going to see a northwesterly flow. Thus, we're going to see the smoke increasing moving through the weekend and decreasing air quality. It's going to keep hot, though, here across northern Utah, south central, southwestern Utah, a threat of an isolated shower. St. George, at least for one day, we see that chance. And then we get a break, and then a bigger spread of monsoon moisture across the state. That'll drop temperatures and see a chance of some scattered thunderstorms by the middle of the week. Northern Utah, it's smoky sunshine, keeping it hot. We start to see that monsoon moisture moving in. Better chance of some afternoon showers, bringing temperatures down to the 80s by Wednesday.